Hi guys, hope you had a lovely weekend. So I'm back with my third video of this Lightning Web Component series. In this video, I'm going to talk about styling, how to add CSS to your markup. So let's see the agenda. So in this video, we'll be talking about inline CSS, external CSS, accessing CSS file from static resources, and shared external CSS. So just a recap of my last video. So in the last video, we talked about templates. So how we create markup using template, then how we do conditional rendering and iteration. So basically how we render the markup. And today we'll be talking about adding styling to that markup. Okay. So there is no much theory in this. Let's directly move to the demo and understand the code, how it works. First, we should go and look at the code. So I have created this component styling example, which is a LWC component, which I have created for showing you how to style text in templates. So you can see there is a template tag. Inside that, I have just added one lightning card. And inside that, I have created this paragraph tag. And in this paragraph tag, I have added few styles like text align center, color blue, background color, then text transformation and margin. And the text is, this text is inline styled. Similar way, I have created this. This text is styled from external file. And this text is styled from static resource. So first thing, we should focus on this line. All the styles are present here only, which are known as, like when you add it in your tag, it is known as inline styling. So whatever styles we want, we can add it here. So let's go and check how it looks on our front end. So this is my line that this text is inline styled. If I just inspect it, I can see all my text align, color, background color, text transformation, and margin present here. Let's go back. Second is external styles. What are external styles? So external styles is, in every Lightning component, Lightning web component, there are few, like there's a particular folder structure that we follow. In that folder structure, we have one HTML file, one JS file, one CSS file, and one meta file. So in the CSS file, we can define all our stylings. So this is the class I have declared here, and I have declared text align left, color as red, background color I have given, then text transformation is uppercase, and margin 5px. So the difference in inline and external CSS that I've done is, inline was color was blue, whereas my external CSS, I have made that color as red. And so let's go and check. I have not refreshed my screen. Yes. So this is the line which was coming from my inline CSS, and this styling, so this is left aligned. So if you check, my external style sheet says text align left and the color is red, which is applied on this text is styled from external CSS file. And I have applied that class on this paragraph tag. So this style has come here, applied on this. And if I inspect this, see this external style is applied on my this paragraph tag, and red left align and all the styles are applied here. Similar way, my third one is, if suppose you want to access some external style sheets from some other library or some other source, then you can upload those CSS files in your static resource. And then I have explained in this how to access your static resource and display your styling. So basically this text will be styled from a static resource. So this says static resource style. Fine. If I go and check my external style sheet, no, nothing is there. There is one more tag, host. I will explain it in the end. But for now, like, the static resource style is not present. Fine. So I'll show you where I have declared that. So this is one of my static resource that I have created, static resource css.css. And in this, I have created this class static resource style, which is text align right, color white, and background color and text transformation. So see this, is it coming? Yes, it is coming. If I inspect this, text align right, color is white, background color and text transformation. Suppose if I say, okay, let me change the color, make it red. Okay, I've saved my style sheet. Let me see if it reflects. Yes, it reflects. Okay, so this way we can, these are the three ways we can style our component. There is one more way, styling using design tokens. If you have worked on Aura components, then you must be knowing about lightning design tokens that we used. So same way, we can refer those design tokens here only. Only the limitation is those tokens should be present in our DOM. Like, so for making it present in DOM, you have to create a separate Aura component and then add it, refer those design tokens, and then it can be referred in our style sheets. And it's just like we can use here with color, like hyphen LWC, and then we can mention the property of the design token and it can be referred here. Okay, then what is this host? So suppose this is my markup and I want to style my whole component, like parent of the component. Okay, then how to style that? So for styling that, in LWC we have this host class. You can just declare colon host and then you can declare the properties. So if I go and see my component, how it is appearing. So if I inspect this, this is the file created. Okay, I check what all styles I gave. I gave border style as double, I gave color to the border and display as block. So see, this border is coming double lined, and these are the styles coming here. So like, if you want to style your parent component container, then you can provide it by colon host. Suppose you have a requirement, okay, this component is put into another component and there are multiple instances of the same component and you have some selection option. Okay, when you select some button, then particular instance of the component should be highlighted or some different styling should be given. In that case, you have context-based host styling as well. So from the parent component, you can pass a class like active or enabled or something. And then you can mention it here, dot active. So now this style will only be applicable when your active class is added from the parent component. And if you remove this, then every time this will be applicable on your component. Okay. So this way we can style our components. Then in winter 20, if you have read the release notes, there is one more new feature given by Salesforce. So in this feature, what you can do is you can create one more component inside LWC folder. And in that folder, you can just create a CSS file like this. Like, you just create styling example, and inside that you can create styling example.css. And then you can refer that just by going to CSS file, writing import. And inside import, you can specify what to import. Okay, import, suppose I say some other hello world is there. So I can say hello world.css. So you just need to import it like this and it can be referred here. So there are different ways to apply your CSS, apply your styling in whichever way you want. But there are some best practices that we should follow. So the best practices is inline styling is avoided. We should not use inline styling as it is specific to that component, but we can reuse the styling. Like you are creating some portal, or you are, suppose you have, if I talk about this page, okay, in this page there are different components. So if I inline style, like this color is here, header color, if I inline style, then I will give this color separately to this component and this color, same color to this separately this component. And in future, I get a requirement to change this color. Okay. So if I go, I search where all this color is referred, I went in this component, I changed this. So it only reflected here, whereas here there was a different, it was set from a different place. So now, what you have to do is go to all the places wherever you have set these colors for headers and go and modify it. So what is suggested is use a generic or a external CSS, which you can just go at one place and change and it will be reflected at all the places. Okay. So if you talk about component level, then all the different attributes of your component should be styled from this external sheet. Or if you are building some portal or like community, then you can create a separate component, a CSS file in that, and you can keep all your CSS classes there and refer those in all your components. So that, like, if you get, say you are building a community, you are asked to change the header color. So you just go to that file and just change the header color and it will be reflected on all the pages. So you do not need to go in all the pages and change those colors. So it will be easy to manage, easy to maintain. Okay, so this is the way we can style our LWC components. Fine, let's go back to our deck. Done. So thank you. This was in our styling video. Next, in our next video, we'll be talking about lifecycle flows, what are different lifecycle hooks that we can use, and how, what is the lifecycle, how a LWC component is rendered. Thank you.